This session, today we discuss very important concept, that is properties of integers under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now let us learn the first property, closure property. What is a closure property? Take any two integers. If you add, subtract or multiply or divide, if the result is an integer, then we say that integers follow closure property. Let us check under addition. Minus 4 plus 2, which is minus 2. 8 plus minus 5, which is 3. So the sum of two integers, we got an integer. It means that integers follow closure property under addition. So generally we say that for any two integers a and b, a plus b is an integer. Let us check under subtraction. Find the difference. 5 minus 3 is 2. 2 minus of minus 5, that is 2 plus 5, which is 7. So the difference of two integers is also an integer. It means that integers follow closure property under subtraction also. So generally we say that if a and b are two integers, a minus b is also an integer. It means that integers follow closure property under subtraction. Now let us check under multiplication. Now find the product. 4 into minus 3 plus into minus minus, 4 3s are 12. Now minus 6 into minus 5, minus into minus plus, 6 5s are 30. The product of two integers is also an integer. It means that integers are closure under multiplication. From this, we can say that for any two integers a and b, a into b is also an integer. Let us check under division. Minus 10 divided by 2. Minus divided by plus is minus. 10 divided by 2 is 5. Now 3 divided by 12, that means 3 by 12. 3 ones, 3 fours, where 1 by 4 is not an integer. So integers are not closed under division. So generally we say that for any two integers a and b, a divided by b is not an integer. So we can conclude from this, integers follow closure property only under addition, subtraction, multiplication, but not in division. Now come to the second property. The second property is commutative property. What is commutative property? Again, you take two integers. If you add, subtract, multiply or divide the two integers in any order, if the result is same, then we say integers follow commutative property. Now let us check under addition. Minus 6 plus 3, which is minus 3. Now here I interchanged the place of the numbers. 3 plus minus 6, which is minus 3. Now you say, is minus 3 is equal to minus 3? Yes. It means that integers follow commutative property under addition. So generally we say that for any two integers a and b, a plus b is equal to b plus a. Let us check under subtraction. Minus 7 minus 3, and I interchanged 3 minus minus 7. Now minus 7, additive inverse of 3 is minus 3. So which is minus 10. Now here 3, additive inverse of minus 7 is plus 7, 3 plus 7 is 10. Is minus 10 is equal to 10? No. It means that integers are not commutative under subtraction. Generally we say that for any two integers a and b, a minus b is not equal to b minus a. Now let us check under multiplication. Now find the product. Minus 7 into 3. Minus into plus minus. 7 3s are 21. Now I interchange the place of the numbers. Plus into minus minus. 3 7s 21. Is minus 21 is equal to minus 21? Yes. It means that integers follow commutative property under multiplication. So generally we say that for any two integers a and b, a into b is equal to b into a. And finally, let us check under division. 50 divided by 10, which is 5. Where 10 divided by 50, what we will get? Which is 10 ones, 10 fives, 1 by 5. Is 5 is equal to 1 by 5? No. It means integers are not commutative under division. So generally we say that a divided for any two integers a and b, a divided by b is not equal to b divided by a. And from this we can conclude integers are commutative only under addition and multiplication, but not under subtraction and division. Now you check these properties by taking few more examples. Property, associative property. What is an associative property? Now take any three integers. By adding or subtracting or multiplying or dividing in any order, if the result is same, then we say that integers follow associative property. Now let us check under addition. 2 plus 3 plus 4 and 2 plus 3 plus 4. The sum of 2 and 3 is added to 4, and here 2 is added to the sum of 3 and 4. Now let us check the result in both cases. 2 plus 3 5 plus 4, which is 9. Now 2 plus 3 plus 4 is 7, 2 plus 7 is 9. As you know that 9 is equal to 9. So we can say that integers follow associative property under addition. In general we say that for any three integers a, b and c, a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c. Now let us check under subtraction. 8 minus 4 minus 2, 8 minus 4 minus 2. From the difference of 8 and 4, we are subtracting 2. Here, from 8, we are subtracting the difference of 4 and 2. 8 minus 4 is 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. 8 minus 4 minus 2 is 2. 8 minus 2 is 6. Is 2 is equal to 6? No. They are not equal. So, we can say that integers are not associative under subtraction. In general, we say that for any three integers a, b and c, a minus b minus c is not equal to a minus b minus c. Now let us check under multiplication. 2 into 3 into 4, 2 into 3 into 4. The product of 2 and 3 is multiplied by 4, and here 2 is multiplied by the product of 3 and 4. 2 3s are 6, 6 into 4, 6 4s are 24. Now here 2 into 3 4s are 12, 2 12s are 24. Is 24 is equal to 24? Yes, they are equal. So we can say that integers are associative under multiplication. So in general we say that for any three integers a, b and c, a into b into c is equal to a into b into c. Now finally we check under division. 8 divided by 4 divided by 2, 8 divided by 4 divided by 2. 8 divided by 4 means 4 2s are 8 divided by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 8 divided by 4 divided by 2 means 2. 8 divided by 2 means 2 4s are 8. Is 1 and 4 are equal? No, they are not equal. It means that integers are not associative under division. So we can say generally, in general we say that a divided by b divided by c is not equal to a divided by b divided by c. So from this we can conclude integers follow associative property only under addition and multiplication, but not in subtraction and division. Now let us learn some more additional properties. First, additive identity. Now here minus 5 plus dash is equal to dash plus minus 5, which is minus 5. By adding which integer to minus 5, we get minus 5 itself? Yes, it is 0. Minus 5 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus minus 5 is equal to minus 5. Here, any integer is added to 0 or 0 is added to any integer, we get an integer itself. It is called additive identity property. In general, we say that for any integer a, a plus 0 is equal to 0 plus a is equal to a. Here, 0 is called additive identity. Now come to the additive inverse. 7 plus minus 7 is equal to minus 7 plus 7 is equal to how much? Here 7 is the additive inverse of minus 7. Minus 7 is the additive inverse of 7. The sum of a number and its additive inverse always 0. So in general we can say that for any integer a, a plus minus a is equal to minus a plus a is equal to 0. Now come to the multiplicative identity. With what number if you multiply 10 here, we get 10 itself? Yes, it is 1. 10 into 1 is equal to 1 into 10 is equal to 10. If any integer is multiplied by 1 or 1 is multiplied by any integer, we get an integer itself. So here we can say in general, a in, for any integer a here, a into 1 is equal to 1 into a is equal to a. Here 1 is called multiplicative identity. Now come to the distributive property. It is very important property. What is distributive property? Distributivity of multiplication of integers over addition. It means that you see here, we are adding two integers and the sum is being multiplied by another integer. This is written as minus 3 into 4 plus minus 3 into 2. Now let us verify this. Now first we'll do within brackets minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2. This is being multiplied by minus 3. Now minus into minus plus 3 2s are 6. Here minus into minus plus 3 4s are 12 plus minus into plus minus 3 2s are 6. 12 plus minus 6 means 6. Is 6 is equal to 6? Yes. Here these two are verified. We got equal answer. From this we can say that in general, for any three integers a, b and c, a into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. This distributive property is true under subtraction also. And some more additional properties we are going to learn here. A into 0 is equal to 0 into a is equal to 0. It means that for any integer a, if any integer is multiplied by 0 or 0 is multiplied by any integer, we get 0. If 0 is multiplied by any integer, we get 0. Suppose if any integer is divided by 0, it is not defined. I hope you understand all these properties very clear. And try exercise 5 sums from textbook basing on these properties. Thank you.